Hey everybody, I am Betsy Paik. I'm a transformational coach, and I help you master your subconscious so that you can manifest the life you truly desire. Now, I'm an NLP coach, and I also coach with EFT, and that's what I'm going to talk to you about today. So EFT stands for Emotional Freedom Technique. And tapping. You may have heard it called tapping. It's actually a technique that was developed by a guy named Gary Craig in the early to mid 90s. It's actually developed from another technique that you may have heard of called TFT. Now, TFT was made by a guy named Dr. Roger Callahan, and it stands for Thought Field Therapy. So you might have heard that. I'm going to explain the difference between the two, but this video is really to teach you the basics of how to use EFT or tapping. So tapping is simply using the self-soothing points on your body to reprogram any sort of negative experience, or as you're experiencing something that is uncomfortable emotionally, to be able to soothe. Now, many of us self-soothe in lots of different ways. We might go shopping, have some retail therapy. We might eat, we might meditate. And another thing you could do is to tap. Now, it uses meridian points on your body similar to the meridian points that are used in acupuncture. So I'm gonna go over those tapping points with you, and then I'm gonna show you how tapping actually is done, the technique and the whole process. Then I'm gonna explain how you could use TFT to do things just a little bit different. So the tapping points are those natural points. So if you could think of, if you had a migraine, right? You'd go like this, right? Or if somebody scared you, you'd go, ah! So those are the natural points. And so those are the tapping points. We're gonna start with a karate chop. Now the karate chop is really the most impactful. There are times where I'm working on something with EFT, and I use this throughout my day at different times, where this is all I need and I can feel a release. So that's my first point. My second point is gonna be right here on top of my head. So not my forehead and not the tippity top, not the crown of my head, but just forward onto my hairline. And then the next one is on my eyebrow. And if you take your finger and you go straight up, that's the point, is right there. Now you can tap with both hands if you want. I find it a little crowded feeling, and so you can get results from just one hand. And then over here, there's like a little indentation here by my eye. That's my next point. Right here where the bone sort of changes, you know, into my eye socket, that's the next point. Right here, it's where my gums and my teeth come together. And then where my gums and my teeth come together here. There's a couple different points on our chest and our collarbone, but if you could find that little hole, the little circle, and then just go to the side, there is a point right there, and you can tap right on that point. This is like a little tender spot right there. And then the last spot is here. It's on my bra line. So right here, I'm just gonna tap away. Okay, so those are the tapping points. The sequence for EFT, I think, matters less than the relief you're getting. Most EFT practitioners will say to do the whole sequence and then see how you feel. That's typically what I do. But because I use this at different times throughout the day, I may get relief just from this. And so I don't make myself do a full sequence. Now, the difference between EFT and TFT is that TFT does care about the sequence. It will have a certain algorithm based on if you're dealing with anxiety or you're dealing with guilt or you're dealing with anger. So it may be that I start tapping here and then I go to here and then I go to here. That may be one algorithm. So you can find these algorithms on the internet if you hit the Google. But for now, we're just going to do EFT, which is just the whole basic thing. So here's how I start. I have something that's making me uncomfortable or something that I want to overcome, and I rate it on a 0 to 10, where do I feel? So if I'm starting at like an 8, say a 7 or an 8, where it feels really uncomfortable, I believe it's really helpful to identify the emotion. But there are times where you can't identify the emotion, you just feel yucky, you don't know maybe like where the source of that came from. I have another technique that I use with that that's really impactful, and I'm gonna talk about that. It's called a gamut. I'm gonna talk about that in another video. So for this one, I recognize the emotion. I'm feeling stress. Where does that come from? It comes from a really busy day with lots of stuff to do, and I'm worried I won't get it done. Okay, so and then I just start tapping. I start to say all, and I rate it, so it's an 8, okay? So I start to say exactly how I'm feeling. Oh my gosh, I feel like I can't get it all done. I feel like I need help, and I don't know why I have to do everything by myself. I feel really overwhelmed, and when I get overwhelmed, it makes me nervous. And I feel like if I don't get it all done, that I'm not good enough. And I see other people get it all done, and they seem to be able to handle it all. And so it makes me wonder why I can't handle it. Now, I notice when I get to like here and here, I want to take a big deep breath. So that's cool. And notice as I'm going through, it's evolving. I'm becoming clearer on what the issue is. So I just keep talking about the issue. I talk about the issue all the way through the whole series. Okay, so now I've done one series. And then I ask myself, where am I now? Has it gone down? Is it a 7? Is it a 4? Is it already at 0? Many times, because I'm doing this regularly and I've done other clearing, you can find out more about some of my other clearing stuff on my website. I have a class called No Limits where we go through a lot of clearing stuff. But because I've already cleared, sometimes I notice just one full round will take it away. Then I want to tell my body. So what I've done is I've told my body, relax, it's okay. You're having this feeling, but I'm reprogramming over it. It's safe, it's safe, it's safe. Now I'm going to reprogram what I want it to believe. So now I just go through the whole list and I say, even though I was feeling really stressed, I know that I am good enough. Even though I'm feeling really stressed, I know that I am worthy of love. So even though I feel really stressed, I completely love and accept myself. And I can even narrow this down so I don't have to go through the whole, even though I felt stressed, or even though I'm feeling better about being stressed, I completely love and accept myself. I can just say, like, completely love and accept myself, completely love and accept myself, love and accept myself. So I can go through that way. Then if I feel good, then I'm done. If I still have issues, if I still feel like kind of yucky, then I can do another round. I could do 2 rounds of the first where I'm actually talking about the problem. And then when I feel better, go to the I completely love and accept myself round. And with that, you should notice a remarkable difference. Now, you can use EFT for, to help you with your food. You can use it to help you with your stress. You can use it for anything that's coming up. You can use it to help release past anger or negativity or trauma. There is a lot of different ways that you can use EFT to help you self-soothe, feel better, and reprogram over that uncomfortable emotion. So I hope that that served you. If you have questions, I do have a story inside my Instagram that is saved with some often questions that I get about EFT. So check those out. And I hope that that served you. And if I can do anything, please feel free to reach out again on my website, betsypaik.com. See you guys later.